This is just a small Stirling engine. You have this alcohol burner down here. And you take the top off of that, fill that with alcohol, and then put the top back on it. The displacer runs up and down inside this test tube, which I assume is a piece of Pyrex. And this will have a somewhat limited runtime because all of this is over the fire. This thing heats up and starts running pretty quick, but then your heat exchanger or your cold zone here is going to heat up real quick. And once you lose the temperature difference here, this thing is going to slow down and quit. And I suggest that you blow this out before it gets so hot that it quits. Do not put any oil or anything on here. You can take a pencil, rub a little graphite on some of these places if you wish. Probably not necessary, at least not now. So you have the hot cylinder and the cold cylinder, and this piece of what appears to be silicone tubing transfers air from the hot end to the cold end back and forth. And with the engine comes a spare glass, a spare wick, and a spare tube. And I suggest you put these pieces inside the glass, place that in something to protect it for future use. This tube just pushes into this upper part of this heat exchanger and into the bottom end of this cylinder for the power piston, and it's just a push fit. There's no barb or anything for it to go over. I'm using denatured alcohol. It burns clean. It doesn't leave any carbon on the glass. Runs pretty fast. And it runs clockwise when viewed from this side. Sounds very true. This will probably run for maybe 2 minutes before it starts to slow down. It says somewhere on the listing that if this slows down too quick for you, you can put a wet towel around here. I suggest you do not do that. If you get a wet towel or something and you touch this hot glass, there's an excellent chance you're going to break that. It's still running pretty well. And considering that this fire is also heating up this section, it runs longer than I expected. You want to be careful and don't touch any of this while it's running, and certainly not after you blow it out. This will all be very hot. From a personal preference, I'm going to blow this out. I don't see any reason to see how hot it can get. And even this brass rod here can be kind of warm. So when you go to move that, you want to be real careful. Better still, let it sit here until the whole thing cools off.